Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafi al-mursaleen. Sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa maulana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. We have all heard that the beginning of 10 days of the month of Ramadan is the days of Rahmah. But we want to emphasize also that Ramadan, all of it is Rahmah. Not confined to that only. Rahmah for those of us who have fallen in error. Rahmah for those of us who have fallen in sin and wrong. And that is the Rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that covers everybody. It includes the pious, it includes the repentance, those that are seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all in this month of Ramadan, making themselves babe, putting themselves there, pleading for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam in Surah Al-Mu'minun, ayah number 118, وَقُلْ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ وَرَحَمْ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And say, O my Lord, forgive me, have mercy, and you are the one that shows the best, you're the best of those that give, that show mercy. So Ramadan, we are at the height of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. He is ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. He is rahmah, the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exceeds his anger. The ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exceeds the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning what? Meaning the rahmah is greater. Meaning the ni'mah, the favors are greater. So this is the time where we cash in. This is the time where you move in towards something like that. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more merciful with you than what you would be with yourself or you with someone else or anybody with you. Allah is more merciful than that. Allow me to bring your attention to a hadith that is narrated in Al-Bukhari and Muslim, rahimahumullah, and sahih. Narrated by Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, and he says that the prisoners of war was brought to the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then there was a woman that she ran around, this woman, Imratun min asabi qad tahlubu thajaha tasqi idha wajadat sabiyan fi sabi أخذته فألسقته ببطنها وأرضعته. فقال لنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. We'll come to that part. About this woman, she went to each, found each where there's children that needed breastfeeding. She would run to them, grab them, feed them, and they give them breastfeeding and so on. And some of the riwayat say she was looking for her own child until she found her own child and breastfed that child. So the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said to his Sahaba, "Atarawna hadihi tarihatan waladaha fin nar?" Do you think such a woman that has been looking for a baby and has now grabbed a child, put it against the chest, give the child breastfeeding the child, would you see that's a possibility that this kind of woman would throw that child into a fire? Is it possible? And they say, "La." They said, no, that's not possible. And even in our time, we will say the same thing. Who's going to throw a baby into the fire? Says the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, لِلَّهِ أَرْحَمُ بِعِبَادِهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ بِوَلَدِهَا. Now Allah Ta'ala is more merciful than that mother that you're talking about. More merciful. So which again means that this is the time to grab that mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because being merciful is also a character that can come from ourselves. And this is a great character, great akhlaq, min khuluq al-kareem, as that a Muslim can have. It is a noble thing when somebody can describe or ascribe you as somebody that is a very merciful person. And one wants to see that it happens throughout the community and so on. The Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith, جعل الله الرحمة مئة جزء فأمسك عنده تسعة وتسعين وأنزل في الأرض جزءا واحدا فمن ذلك الجزء تتراحم الخلائق حتى ترفع الدابة حافرها عن ولدها خشية أن تصيبه. Says the Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made 100 parts of mercy. 100 parts. Mi'ata juz. فَأَمْسَكَ عِنْدَهُ تِسْعَةً وَتِسْئِينَ Allah ta'ala had held back 99 of these parts of mercy. وَأَنْزَلَ فِي الْأَرْضِ جُزْءًا وَاحِدًا Only sent one part to the earth. One part Allah Ta'ala had only sent down to the earth. And it is from that one part, min dhalika al-juz, you see that everybody has mercy with one another. Just that one part of juz that Allah Ta'ala had sent, people show mutual love, they show mutual mercy to one another. Hatta tarfa' dabatu hafiraha an waladiha khashyata an tusibahu. Even to the extent where an animal would raise their leg from their or their foot from their child so that they don't hurt their own baby. An animal, so far as that one rahmah gone. So therefore, let us take note. The greatest rahmah that Allah Ta'ala had granted you and me and all of the believers, all of the Muslimin, is the fact that we are Muslim. Is the deen of Islam that Allah Ta'ala had given us, and Allah Ta'ala attaches his barakah with that rahmah. You know, if you were to look in the different ayat in the Holy Quran, you will see that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala attaches many times his rahmah with hidayah. Rahmah with guidance. Let me give you one example. In Surah Ali Imran, please go read it up. Ali Imran, ayah number 8. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبَ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابُ. I'm sure everybody knows the dua that we always make. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. Oh Allah, don't let our hearts swerve after you have guided us. Hidayah. وَهَبَ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً and grant us from your mercy. Hidayah and rahmah. Guidance and mercy. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابِ you are the best of bestowers. And again, we see when we are faced with calamity, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَالنَّقْصِ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ It's a host of calamities that we go through on the dunya that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end says about the sabireen, those who have patience and perseverance, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ Shortly, the ulama explains that when a calamity befalls you, then face the calamity with iman and taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't lose yourself. Don't question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you do that, then you're going to miss the rahmah that comes with the calamity. Because with every calamity comes mercy, comes rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you meet it up with iman and taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you meet up with this, وَلَيْكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ Allah ta'ala says, those people, what do we say when we have a loss? We say, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجُونَ From Allah we come and to Allah will return. From Allah it came, to Allah it will return. These kind of people, Allah Ta'ala says, who shows that kind of sabr, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. Allah places salawat on them. صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ. See, there's the rahmah. You meet up with the rahmah even in the time of calamity. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. Allah Ta'ala testifies that they are truly guided. May Allah Ta'ala grant us rahmatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rahmah on the world and humanity at the moment as we face the pandemic of coronavirus. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.